Hello and welcome to the course DA7650 Advanced Computer Networks. This lecture is meant for 4th year students, those who are in 8th semester. This is the 5th lecture of Module 5 and we will continue our discussion on network management design. So let's begin. If you remember, we are talking about, or we have already completed the discussion on some protocols that are used for network management, and those are SNMP, MIB and RMON. And today's lecture is on the discussion of Cisco NetFlow and Syslog. So let's begin with the discussion, that is Cisco NetFlow. So generally Cisco NetFlow is a technology that allows the measurement of flow that pass through a device. So here a device means a router, maybe in case of a Cisco router maybe. So it will measure the flow of data along the router. So what do you mean by a flow? Network flow. A network flow is a unidirectional streams of packets between a given source and a destination. So if you think about this is a router, whenever data comes from a network, from outside network and to your home network, then that flow or unidirectional packets that are coming from the outside network is called the network flow. And in granular level, means if you think about what is a network flow in a granular level, then we can say a flow can be defined by the source and destination IP address, source and destination port number, protocol types, type of service and interfaces. So what do you mean by that flow? That flow means it can be a packet. If you remember in IPv4 packet, what is the contents there? You can see there is a source and a destination IP address will be there. And obviously it contains some port number, that is source port number and destination port number, to specify the application for which the packet is meant. And we have to check about the protocol type, that means whether it is a TCP connection or whether it is a UDP connection or maybe HTTP connection. So accordingly the packets are different for each connection type. And the type of services that are present in your act as a field in your IPv4 packet. And a input interface means the interfaces from which the data came from, because in a router there will be every interface is numbered, that is 1, 2, let this may be 3, and from which interface that is coming to your home network, that need to be recorded. So NetFlow has two key components. So what are the key components? The NetFlow gate, and which stores the flow information. So what is a flow information that I have already talked about it, and the NetFlow export mechanism, which sends the flow data to a network management collector for data reporting. So we know that a network management system is there who is trying to manage the network flow, so that data can be transferred to computer or the network flow manager. Well, to understand each point in a greater detail, I have used a figure in the next slide. So that will be looking like this. This is a router through which the networks are going to come. Let's your home network will be here and it is connected to this interface. Let's say the interface number is 1, this is interface number 2 and this is interface number 3. Now let us say one packet arrived at your network, okay, through your router. Then that packet, whenever processed inside your router, the router will identify the data which are coming from the outside network, whether any communication has been made beforehand or not with that particular device. If he could not find any information about this communication, then he could store the data about this message into a table. So that table, or that is called network cache, as I have already discussed, that will be a NetFlow cache. Okay, so the NetFlow cache which stores the flow information. So what the flow information contents, that we have already discussed, those are containing your source IP, destination IP, source port, destination port, protocol type, TOS and input interface. So here the input interface will be 2 and maybe the source IP address will be, let's say, 13.2.1.6. Maybe the destination IP address will be 2.2.3.5, and let me the source port may be 80, destination port may be 65 and so on. So these data will be recorded in the cache. Then after the data gets recorded, maybe other packets are going to be transferred through these devices, and the stream of packets has been stored. Some other value may came and we will store the values over here in the cache memory. After the cache memory get filled up, then the your router will trying to transfer the data to the network flow collector. Sorry, that is called net flow collector. So here the data will be transferred row wise, every data will be transferred here, and later on when the data are getting over here, that data may be transferred to your network manager. So that network manager will manage the will check the data, which from which interface it is coming, what type of data is this, whether any debug messages, or it may be contain any virus or something like that. If some kind of things will be there, then he may inform the router to not to receive those kind of data. So this is coming under your network management concept. So that Cisco NetFlow is working like this. So I hope you understand the concept of Cisco NetFlow. So let's go for the discussion of the syslog. So before I read about these messages, these points, let us discuss in the figure itself. So we know that similar kind of thing that like NetFlow, Cisco network devices such as routers and switches produces messages. So generally, if you consider a router or a switch, they generally produces messages. That messages is looking like this. This is the format of that messages. What are the different fields on these messages, that we are going to discuss in the next slide. But let us understand what this message format and why it, and what this message conveys to a particular system or to the network. Okay. So generally, whenever a message has been arrived, we know that the router has been connected through different input interface and some output interface. So whenever the data came from an input interface, that message will be transferred. This message are sent to the console session by default, but the device can be configured to send the message to syslog server. So I am showing both the things here. It is a console. This is the syslog server. When the message arrived at the router, or it may be arrived at the switch, then that message will be directly shown in the console, and whoever the network monitoring person who is sitting in front of this console will check that message for any error or some problems in the network or not. So that every message will be transferred from this router or the switches to this console directly, and this is the default one. So by default the data are transferred to the console. But without using the default method, we can also able to transfer those data or to want to store that messages in a syslog server. So whenever the data are transferred for storing purpose, so that will be stored inside a syslog server, and later on this is the content of this syslog server may be transferred to your network manager, who will check the problems or the errors present in the network. Right, a syslog server is a server that runs a syslog application, a standard for logging system messages. Okay, the messages can then be retrieved. So later on, the messages can then be retrieved and analyzed by the network manager. So as I have already talked about this, so syslog server will store that message and transfer this message to your network manager, and network manager will analyze the content or the messages. Now that you understand what is the concept of syslog, let us understand what is this message format and what this message format contains one by one. Right. So this is the message format, and you can know that there is a point called severity. Actually, the network manager who is sitting in front of a computer or the console, he is trying to see the value coming under the severity part. All other things are very general, but severity part plays the most important role over here. And that defines the if any problem will occur, then how to handle that network, means when to handle that network. Actually, the messages are coming in a natural process. So the first line, that is MMDDYYHHMMSS, this is the timestamp at what date and which time the message has generated by the router or the switch. Facility refers to the hardware devices, protocols or module of the system software to which the message pertains, means for which device has been facilitated these messages, or from which devices, because there are several devices that may be connected to the network, like router, there will be switches, there will be some system software installed on that. So who is the person who has sent these messages to the server? Okay. Then the most important part of this is your severity. So severity is a number from 0 to 7 that indicates the severity of the conditions, means if any problem occurs over there. So that numbers are identified by these definitions. So if this is a level 0, then that will be highest level and it is the emergency problem. Means immediately you have to look after the network and something is happening in the network. That's why that message has been came. Might be the router has failed or something like that. So that's why this message has came. So immediately we have to look after the network by seeing the value 0 over here, the severity message. If it is 1, then that will be alert. If 2, then critical. 3, it is a error. And if level 4, then it is a warning. The level 5, it is a notice. And level 6, then it is informational. And level 7, it will be debugging case. So according to the severity, you can attend the network and try to monitor the network so that no problem will occur inside your network. So next part is your mnemonic. And mnemonic is nothing but it is uniquely identify the error messages. So there are several messages are coming are stored inside the devices inside your syslog server. So you to identify particular message, you need a unique identifier for that. So that mnemonic value will be showing you the actual means how to identify that particular message. Then the last one is your message text. So the message text is containing all other part of this communication or the packet. Let's say it will be a text string that further describes the event, including addresses, port number and so forth. So everything that message may specify, suppose it is coming from a particular network interface, so the interface number may be included, maybe the port number may be included for which the message has came. So everything has to be recorded. And later on, it should be transferred to the network manager for analysis. So that's all about syslog. And we have already discussed the Cisco NetFlow. That's all for today's class. Thanks for listening. And you know that we have already, mentioned the reference. So all the contents are collected from this book itself. So you are required to go to that book, the chapter number 9. And thanks for listening. Bye-bye.